So in the last couple lectures, we've been talking about variables and the different types of variables. In this lecture, we're going to give you different examples of the types of variables in statistics. So let's get started. So here I'm going to give you an example of a quantitative variable. Remember, these are basically numerical in nature. So age, height, weight, temperature, these are all things that you can measure with some sort of unit. Age could be measured in years, height could be measured in inches, weight could be measured in pounds, temperature can be measured in Celsius. There's all different types of ways of measuring these things too. So these things are quantitative variables in nature. So here are some examples of qualitative variables, things that you can't really measure with a ruler, like eye color. It's descriptive in nature. Gender is descriptive in nature. Emotional status, maybe you're angry, maybe you're sad, you can't really measure it. And you know, doctors might try to measure that last one with like on a scale of 1 to 10, but it's still descriptive in nature. You can't really measure it with a ruler. Now in the last lecture, we found out that there's two types of numerical variables. Here's some examples of the first type, which are discrete variables. So we have age. Your age can only be like, you know, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, and I can go up to maybe 130. And at that point, I'd probably be able to guess your age. So there are only a limited number of options that you can have for your age. Shoe size. I can guess that your shoe size is probably one in about 24 numbers. Maybe it's 1.5, 2, 2.5, 3, 3.5, 4, 4.5, 5. Your shoe size is probably not going to be 8.63287. It's probably going to be like maybe 10.5. So there are limited options that you would give in response if I asked you the question, what is your shoe size? Lastly, the number of purses that you have. You're not going to tell me I have about 5.5 purses. You're going to tell me I have 4 purses, 1 purse, 0 purses, 3 purses, 10 purses. Now in this example, there's no real limit to how many number of purses you can have. Someone might have like a billion purses. So there are still actually an infinite number of options for the possible responses that someone can give, but you're still kind of limited in terms of what type of response you're going to give me. You're going to give me a discrete response because you're only going to give me an integer value, a whole number value, or I guess a natural number in this case because you can give the number 0. So the number of purses is another example of a discrete variable. Examples of continuous variables would be something like height or weight or temperature or income. These things could be measured with rulers, guaranteed, and on top of that, I can be as precise as I want to be. So for example, height, I can go to 5, 10, 20, 30 decimal places if I wanted to. I can get very, very specific depending on how I measure my sample. Weight, I can go to pounds. I will probably only go to, you know, 2 decimal places, but I can be more specific if I need to be. Temperature, I can be as precise as I need to be. Income, this one is a little bit shaky. This one you could dispute is a discrete variable because you only go to 2 decimal places, which really limits the number of options. But technically, some people might say, well, that's actually really specific. So when you start getting into specific values like that to 2 decimal places, it really becomes like a kind of like a continuous variable. So that one's kind of up for debate, that last one. But if you want to think about continuous variables, think about height, think about weight, think about temperature. Those things, you can be as precise as possible if you need to be. Anyways, thank you guys so much, and I'll see you in the next video. You just watched a video from Amore Learning. We provide free math videos, and we offer many online courses. We also provide free math tutoring via YouTube Live every Thursday and Sunday at 9 p.m. Eastern Time. Make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel and like this video to get access to all of our free content. And put a comment in the comment section if you have any math questions. Check out all of our courses on amorelearning.org.